Hi, good morning. To continue with the saga of real vector spaces, I was asked this question. I stopped where we were talking about a spanning set for vector spaces, right? So somebody asked, well, is there a natural way of generating a spanning set for a vector space? And that's what I'm going to try to answer today. Well, let's review what I gave you last time. I was looking at the vector space P sub 2, right? Which was a set of polynomials of degree less than or equal to 2, including the zero polynomial. And I think, yeah, I gave you one example. I looked at the set consisting of the polynomials t squared plus 1, t squared plus t, and t plus 1. Okay? So what we did was we said, well, in order to answer the question whether this set spans P2, so that was the question. So what we did was we took an arbitrary polynomial at squared plus bt plus c, which is an element of P2, right? And we tried to see if we can write it as some, let's say, d1 t squared plus 1 plus d sub 2 t squared plus t. All right, did I use r? Anyway, whatever letter I use, okay? You wanted to see if you can write it as a linear combination of these three, okay? And what happened was, so we ended up with a system, right? The system looked something like this. Let me just copy from my notes. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, A, B, C. And we did a row operations or pivoting, and we got something like the identity matrix, right? 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. I don't even think I did it for you. But anyway, you got some number here, number here, number here. In terms, of course, of A, B, and C. The fact that we were able to reduce this augmented matrix to something like this, where the coefficient matrix is the identity matrix, means that the answer to this is yes. Okay? If we look at the next example, I don't think I did this in the video. If I have t squared plus 1, t minus 1, t squared plus t, okay? We do the same exercise to answer the same question, okay? So we take an at squared plus bt plus c and figure out if we can write it as some d1 or r1, a real number, times t squared plus 1 plus r sub 2 times t minus 1 plus r sub 3, t squared plus t. And so you start with a system that looks like a 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, negative 1, 1, 1, 0, A, B, C. And you do what you want, pivot, row operations, and stuff like that. And we ended up with 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Something, 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 not zero. Okay, in terms of A, B, C, in my notes, I hope I did not mess this up, I got C minus A plus B. Okay, so if we're going to read this, let's look at this. So this means to say that this row actually tells me that this is going to be, this is what kind of system? In general, A, B, and C are any numbers, right? But we have here 0 equals some number. So this is the bad row, right? It gives you the bad equation. So that means to say that what we get is an inconsistent, what we have is an inconsistent system. And that means to say the answer to this is no, right? If you ask the question, does it span P2? The answer is no. Because you cannot find, it is not possible to find real numbers R sub 1, R sub 2, and R sub 3, so that you can, when you form the linear combination, you get an arbitrary polynomial in P2, at squared plus bt plus c. So I guess that's a recap of how to check whether a given set of vectors spans a vector space, okay? So if you look here, okay, so you say, well, that's why somebody asked, so, okay, if this spans P2, well, it's kind of hard to think of this polynomials, right? T squared plus 1, t squared plus t, and t plus 1, all right? Like, somebody could come up with this, and that guy won't produce a spanning set. So the question that arose was, is there a natural way of doing it? And actually, you can draw inspiration from this, is you just want to write a given polynomial as a linear combination of polynomials from P2. So what's a natural choice for that? Again, if we look at P2, P sub 2, we know that an arbitrary polynomial in P sub 2 looks like an AT squared plus BT plus C, right? And there you go, right there, you see you have your A times T squared plus B times T plus C times 1. This is a polynomial in P sub 2. This is also a polynomial in P sub 2. And of course, the constant polynomial 1 is also in P sub 2, right? This is degree 2, degree 1, degree 0, and they all make it, right? They're all polynomials in P sub 2. That means to say that if you grab the set consisting of T squared, T and 1, then that's a natural spanning set for P sub 2, okay? So hopefully you get the idea. So if you have P sub 3, for instance, then that's degree 3 or less, right? AT cubed plus DPT squared plus C, okay? No, sorry, plus CT plus D, right? Okay, you have all these A, B, C, and D are any real numbers. Then a natural spanning set for P sub 3 is T cubed, T squared, T, and 1. Okay, so I hope you got that. So actually for other vector spaces that we have discussed already, so let's say if we have R2, R sub 2, the elements of R sub 2 look like this, right? Okay, AB, two components. Notice that we can write AB as A times 1, 0 plus B times 0, 1. Therefore, a natural spanning set for R sub 2 is the set consisting of 1, 0 and 0, 1. All right? Get the idea? So now if you have R3, R3 will look like ABC. Elements in R3 look like ABC, right? So that's A times 1, 0, 0 plus B times 0, 1, 0. Plus C times 0, 0, 1. So you get it now? Okay. So therefore, a natural spanning set would be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. So now that we know how to do that, we can do more, right? Okay. So let's say we have, these are the column vectors. For the row vectors, let's say if you have R3, elements of R3 will look like A, B, C, right? Like this. So then you know that the natural spanning set for this R3 space is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay? If we have, let's say, the matrices. Let's say if we have M sub 2, 2, 2 by 2 matrices, okay? So the elements will look like A, B, C, D, correct? Okay? So then you'll have, what is it? Okay, so the spanning set will be the set consisting of the matrices 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Basically, you just move those ones, right? Okay? 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Get it? Okay? And that's a natural spanning set for M2, 2. If I make it M3, 2, for instance, then you know that, well, how many do you think you'll have for your spanning set? Yeah, you'll have 6 of these, okay? 3 by 2 matrices. And I think you get the idea. I don't have to bore you with that, okay? So that's how you do it for spanning sets, natural spanning sets for vector spaces.